alternate title for this video. If you plan on retiring this century, you should really learn more about Bitcoin. What's up YouTube, it's your boy Rhett, back at it again with another video. Exciting times here. As of the end of July, I have bought Bitcoin every single day for the last 2 years. I really like talking about Bitcoin dollar cost averaging content, not just to like flex on YouTube, but because I've seen so much scammy Bitcoin content out there about, oh, get rich quick, and oh, invest in this crazy token that no one's ever heard of, it's the future of finance. And I wanna do my part to combat that advice that's all over the internet with an air of legitimacy and sort of meshing Bitcoin, this new financial asset, with tried and true investing principles like dollar cost averaging. Also because, in my opinion, not financial advice, Bitcoin is a much better store of value than stocks, bonds, and all the other traditional assets that we all have sitting in our retirement accounts. So if you watch the end of this video, I'm going to be sharing how much the Bitcoin dollar cost averaging strategy has made over the last 2 years. I'll show you how much you would have made if you had invested just $1 a day over those 2 years into Bitcoin. We'll be doing a comparison with traditional 401k investments to see how Bitcoin stacks up against your 401k. And then finally, we're gonna be talking about CAGR, which if you don't know what CAGR is, definitely watch to the end of the video. You're gonna learn a lot. Go down below, smash the like button, and let's level up your brain. One of the first videos that I made here on YouTube about a year ago was how well this strategy has done over the first year of executing the strategy. That video is really, really horrible. So if you wanna see how much better the production quality of these videos has gotten over the last year, definitely go check that video out. I wasn't even looking in the camera, I was a complete idiot. Anyway, at the time of filming that video, Bitcoin was just below $10,000, and over that first year of executing the strategy had returned about 18%, which at the time I was really happy with. As of the filming of this video, however, Bitcoin is worth around $44,000, and the strategy has profited about 240%. So that amount of profit is obviously crazy, and we'll look at Bitcoin versus some traditional investments later on in the video to give you a good example of, all right, how high really is 240%. Spoiler alert, it's way higher than the S&P 500. As of today, the strategy has lost money in 3 of the last 24 months, with February of 2021 having a cost basis of about $45,000, which is just slightly higher than the current price. And then both March and April of 2021 having an average cost basis of about $55,000, which is a more considerable amount higher than 44,000. Interestingly enough, in that first video that we did a year ago, there were also 3 months out of those first 12 months that had lost money as well. But as of the recording of this video today, those 3 months that had lost money last year are now all up about 300%, which I think just goes to show you that it's important to not get focused in little minutia details about, oh, this month is profitable, this month is not profitable, but to instead zoom out and see, okay, well, over a year, this month has actually gone up 300%. That's a really, really great return. The best part about Bitcoin that traditional finance still hasn't been able to figure out is you can actually dollar cost average into Bitcoin with very, very, very small amounts of money. Over in traditional finance, for the most part, you still have to buy entire shares of companies or entire shares of index funds. You can't just take a dollar and purchase whatever you want. Platforms like Robinhood are actually big outliers in this way, and you still can't put your retirement accounts on Robinhood, so I'm sort of gonna ignore that as an option. Luckily, over in Bitcoin, you can own as little as one Satoshi, which is 1/100,000,000th of a Bitcoin. So if we pretend that you had actually invested only a dollar a day in Bitcoin over the last 2 years, you would have invested $730 total, and you would have ended up today with something around $2,450 as of the recording of this video. So a dollar a day is really, you know, not a lot of money, and it shows that anyone could really be doing the strategy. It's just a matter of knowing that it's even an option. People pay more than a dollar a day or about a dollar a day for regular services all throughout society. I think Netflix now is like $19 a month, which is like 60 cents a day or something. It's very likely that if you cancel all your subscriptions, you could actually take all of that money and invest way more than $1 a day in Bitcoin, but let's stick at a dollar for now just because it's a nice round figure. And we can use that number to make comparisons later on to what if you had done the same thing in a 401k. So if you take a look at this graph that charts how well this strategy has done over time, you can actually see that we're about 30% down from some of the all-time highs that we had back in April. And if we look all the way back to March of 2020, you can barely make out that we actually dropped 50% in a single day. We dropped from around $200 to around $100 or $110. But obviously, if we zoom out and we look at this chart as a whole, you can actually barely tell that we ever lost half of our money in a single day. And actually, that dollar that we invested on that day when the market dropped by 50% is actually a lot more valuable than most of the other dollars that we've invested over the last 2 years are now. And that really illustrates why it's important to zoom out and see this whole thing from the big picture view, especially especially when you're dealing with very volatile assets like Bitcoin. Human psychology is telling us to sell when everyone else is selling and the price is really low, and then to buy more when everyone else is buying more and the price is really high. And this is obviously a great recipe for not making very much money and actually losing money if you decide to sell when the market's at a bottom. The most helpful thing that I've done for myself is to remove this human psychology element from dollar cost averaging totally, which is why I really, really like set it and forget it dollar cost averaging strategies like the one that I made in the Gemini API video, and then also services that you can sign up for like Swan Bitcoin. Because we are really our own worst enemies when it comes to investing, and then having that psychology tell us to sell when the price is low and buy when the price is high. And this is especially true in very volatile assets like Bitcoin, where you're seeing huge gains and huge losses in single days or over weeks or months. So next, let's do a quick comparison of how this Bitcoin dollar cost averaging strategy has done compared to, let's say, a 401k dollar cost averaging strategy, which is something that most of us that are employees are using as a retirement account today. In my 401k, most of my money is tied up in an S&P 500 mutual fund. So let's compare just Bitcoin to the S&P 500. So if you would dollar cost average $1 a day or about $30 a month into the S&P 500 over the last 2 years, you would have again invested the same $730 like you did back in the Bitcoin strategy. But now, since you invested in the S&P 500 instead of investing in Bitcoin, you would have only been left with $950. Give or take, this doesn't really account for any of the fees that you might have paid to your 401k. It could actually be worse than this. This $950 that you're left with represents a 29% gain over the money that you invested. And that's actually about 8 times worse than that Bitcoin dollar cost averaging strategy. At this point, some skeptics might be like, yeah, okay, Rhett, great anecdotal data, cool flex, glad you made so much money with Bitcoin. Poor me, I had to only invest in stocks. I'm only up 29%. But 401ks are a great stable investment, and Bitcoin is this speculative thing no one understands.
So to combat all of those people, let's take a look at Bitcoin's CAGR, or compounding annual growth rate, and see how this trend is actually really clear, and it's not just some anecdotal data that I'm making up or that's unique to my situation. So first, let's talk about what the f*** is CAGR. CAGR is a measure over a certain period of time, and it's basically showing you what is the average growth of some asset each year over that period of time. So it's sort of smoothing out all of the highs and lows and giving you, okay, if this asset had just increased a certain amount every year to get from the beginning point to the end point, what would that certain amount that it increased every year be? And so the formula to find CAGR is you take the amount that the asset is worth at the end divided by the amount that it's worth at the beginning. You raise that whole thing to 1 over the number of periods, and then you subtract 1 to get the percentage. So if you had an asset that was worth $100 in the first year and $200 in the 10th year, you'd do your math and you'd come up with a CAGR of around 7%. And then you could confirm that this math was correct by taking your $100, multiplying by 7% a year for 10 years, and you would eventually end up with something close to $200. Over the last 10 years, for example, the S&P 500's CAGR has been about 11%. Gold's has been about 2%. Tesla has had a CAGR of about 63%, which is actually crazy high. And then US Treasuries have had a CAGR of about 4.5%. Meanwhile, Bitcoin has blown them all out of the water, and Bitcoin's CAGR is actually just below 200% a year over the last 10 years. At this point, the skeptics will come back. I can hear them right now.
Yeah, but Rhett, most of those gains came from when Bitcoin was really, when it was not worth very much money, and then it became worth a lot of money really in the early days, and that's where all that CAGR is coming from, Rhett. You can't really get a CAGR that high anymore, man.
Again, the skeptics, great point. Really A+ analysis from these guys. So next, let's take a look at every single period in between the 2-year period and the 10-year period and see how Bitcoin's CAGR has stacked up to the S&P 500 and to gold.
Bruh.
So over every single period, the 2-year period, the 3-year period, all the way up to the 10-year period, Bitcoin's CAGR has drastically outperformed the S&P 500 and gold. And Bitcoin's CAGR has only fallen below 100% compound annual growth rate for 2 time periods of the last 10 years. You can see that when this data was taken back in March of 2021, when we were sort of at a high point in the Bitcoin price, that over the last 2 years, the Bitcoin CAGR has actually been higher than it's ever been in the history of Bitcoin. Which is why I keep telling people that it's not ever too late to learn about Bitcoin, and why those critics and the people that think that all of the money accrued to the people that bought it at the very beginning are just wrong. It's definitely true that the people that bought it at the very beginning, you know, are probably fabulously wealthy if they held to today, but most of them didn't hold to today. I'd say it's actually way more common, and it's definitely true of everyone that I know that bought Bitcoin back in 2012 that they sold it in 2013 or they sold it in 2014 when it went up 10x or 100x because it wasn't serious at that point. But as it gets bigger and bigger, it actually gains more and more legitimacy. And now it's starting to be looked at by institutions as a store of value and a way to exit this devaluing dollar, inflationary economic policy that we're actually forced into. So I see Bitcoin not as a get rich quick scheme, which is what it's commonly portrayed as on the internet, but as a way to actually take the work and the output that I've created now early in my life and carry that into the future so that I can retire off of that work and that my future dependents can also be supported by the labors that I've done now and have carried into the future basically with Bitcoin. If you think about doing that same thing with the US dollar, you know that that's impossible because the dollar is getting devalued. The government will tell you that it's being devalued at 2 to 5% a year. But if you look at like the cost of treasuries, like how much does it cost to buy a treasury that yields you $50,000 a year in interest, that amount has more than 10x'd over the last decade. And so if you measured inflation that way, the annual inflation rate would be like 15%. And so you know that if you keep money in a savings account that's yielding 0% interest and you try to take that into retirement, it's not gonna work. I feel like more and more people are waking up to that and they're turning to the stock market. And some people are turning to Bitcoin, but I think a lot of people are turning to Bitcoin for the wrong reasons. Bitcoin is absolutely not a get-rich-quick scheme, and I think that if you try to day trade Bitcoin, you could really f*** yourself up by hitting the wrong points of volatility, right? You could get hit, if you really need the money, selling on that day that it drops by 50%, when in reality, you should be trying to hold for a long period of time to ride out that volatility. Again, that's all my opinion, and that's sort of how I think about Bitcoin. I think investing for the long term is really the most credible way to invest. And it's really unfortunate. I still do see a lot of short-term investors talking about Bitcoin on YouTube. So if you are new to Bitcoin or if you are new to investing in general, definitely start by learning about some of the fundamentals of investing. You can read books like A Random Walk Down Wall Street to learn more about how investing works and what investing is. And then if you guys do have any other questions about compounding annual growth rate or Bitcoin dollar cost averaging or really anything that we talked about in this video, go ahead and leave those questions down in the comments. I do still respond to all the comments. If you guys are new to Bitcoin dollar cost averaging, definitely check out the video, I'll link it up here, that I did to the Gemini API. It is the lowest fee way to dollar cost average Bitcoin. So definitely check that out if you are new to this. Go down below and like the video if you learned something so that we can spread credible Bitcoin education throughout YouTube. I think that that's actually really important to get the short-term thinking people out of here. And then subscribe and hit the notification bell for new videos every Monday at 10 a.m. Eastern. I love you all. Goodbye.